Casey.
Thank you, everyone, and welcome to the Student Center at DePaul University in Chicago. We are especially pleased to be participating in this new partnership. We think that we're exploring new ways of meaningful learning that will connect talented musicians from around the world, and we're especially pleased to be host to this particular evening with Maestro Pinchas Zukerman, one of the world's most celebrated musicians, leading a master class of four students from DePaul University, Roosevelt University, Northwestern University, and the Civic Orchestra of Chicago. We expect to have a very wonderful, informative, and fulfilling evening, and it's my pleasure to introduce Maestro Pinchas Zukerman. Maestro.
Hi. Are you? Okay. That's that far?
Right.
Oh, there. How many, David, was it one summer you went to the permacamp?
No, it's my fifth this summer.
This is your fifth? I thought they only took little ones. You were little. 5 years ago you were what, 13? 14. So you're going again this summer?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Did you see Daniel Kalikov?
No.
Last summer?
No.
No? Oh, you probably don't. Oh, that's right. That's right. You're right.
Thank you.
Good, good, good. You obviously love to play the violin. I can tell. You really love it. And you really want to express yourself, right? So you'd like to express yourself better, right? Okay. What we have to do in a very short time like this, I have to show you a few components, okay, of might help you. The first thing that might help you is if you open up the way you hold your bow, if you just spread your fingers a little bit more, so you have, yeah, a little more. That's right. So you have more balance. You have go like that, up and down. Up to here, there's no weight. And then bring it down so you feel the shifting of the weight, right? That's right. Even more. Look, you're still already closing. Yeah. It's like a pair of shoes, you know? The way you hold the ball, it looks like a very small pair of shoes, you know? Squeezing your hand. You need a couple of sizes bigger, okay? Here. There. Yeah, that's better. Now just put it down on the first note. Without the body, just the fingers, just feel the fingers and the thumb catching and let go. Catch, release. And hold the sound. And come back up. So you feel the shift of the weight. Again. Shift the weight, yeah. Catch. Big circle. Circle. Circle with the whole arm. Catch, release. And back again. Keep doing it. Now put the elbow into it. Up and down. Up and down. Catch, release. Adjust your fingers. Adjust your fingers. Ah, girl, once more. That's better. Now, open the angle as you play. One direction, not two, okay? Pretty good. More weight. I'll give you a little resistance. Push me down with the elbow. Not so fast. Just there, not there. That's the weight you want. Push down, all right. How many times did Patty do that with you, David? A lot, good. I'm just checking on her, you know what I mean? Kidding. Come on, push. There now, just feel that weight. And open your posture. That's right, open. As you play, a little bit. Again, catch. Readjust the fingers. Yeah. Ooh, watch where you're putting it. Watch the bow, and out. That's the one, okay? Now, when you get there, retrieve, catch. Detaché. That's a really, it's one of these, you know, it's one of these fingerings. Oh, I don't know. Ouch. That really hurts. Look. Okay. Should I write it down? Somebody throw me a pencil. I hope you don't mind if I change it. Okay. Yeah, just play. That's good. 2-0-1-1. No. 2, you have it. 2-3-4. 2-0-1-1. What do you have here? Third position, right? Third position. No. 2-2-2. Like you have. There, girl. You know it. Okay. Good. But the bow is what's gonna make it. Make the sound. Try again. Catch. Retrieve. No, you picked up. It's not a retrieve. Once more. pinky on that stick. And then when you get there, catch it. For now. Good. Once more. Once more. The whole thing. That's right. Lift. Big lift. 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 Mortal lift. G-string, you're a little too hunched over. You don't need to go so much. Oh, let me talk about that bar. Spitz, tip, travel. In the middle, frog. That's pretty good. Do it again. Watch your direction. Watch the direction. Catch every note. Watch your direction. You're going. Oh, watch your direction. What is it? No, it's too much. You've traveled too much. Travel. Pick up. Pick up for the chord. Prepare the chord. So much sound, you don't know what you're doing. You don't need this. You need this. Curl the fingers, bend your thumb, and catch. But don't catch the frog. And release. More pressure, more speed. You watch your direction. Out and up, so you shift the weight again. That's it. Spread those fingers. Once more. Almost, but I don't like that left side. Why are you doing that? Two bars. The two bars. From the beginning. Ah, you didn't catch. Catch. Now play real detaché. Chin over a little bit. Towards the tailpiece. Yeah. Once more. Do it one more time. Detaché. 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 Yeah, we have to do it a little bit slower again. Detaché. forget it's Brahms. It's a nice Brahms etude. You know, like Rode etude, Kreutzer etude, Gavinier etude, Brahms etude. Lift. Stay at the tip. Tip. Travel. Lift. For about 6 months, that first page. First page is 6 months. And there's more written than notes. There's more language than notes at the end of the 6 months. Okay, yeah, but you know what happens? Everything else that connects to this. Because there are many strokes of this that belong to other pieces. So it's much easier later on. Right? Okay. So when you wake me up at midnight, 2 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, the beginning of Brahms concerto. Trust me, that's what you're going to hear. Unfortunately, I do also get a little anxious when you go on stage. So you forget your fundamentals. So sometimes it doesn't sound so good. You know what I do? I go back to the hotel and remind myself. Or home. Okay? That's what I keep doing. All right? All my life, unfortunately, that's what has to happen. Okay? Go. Don't worry about me. Okay, now let's go to the next one, because they're getting bored. Yeah, lift, a yum, scoop. Right, you want it. Martale. Catch that chord. Like the other one. Like this one, that one. Okay, let's do that again. So, yum, ba, ba, direction. Try and stay more towards the tip here, and then gradually come up. It's the same idea as the triplets, okay? Watch that first A natural. You got in the bottom. Watch that bow so it doesn't start smearing. Okay. Catch. Basically, what we have here is his idiom, his DNA, if you want, okay, his way of writing music, which comes down to 6-5-4-3-2-1, right? We have 6 tuplets, we have quintuplets, we have 4-3-triplets-2-1. And if you do that, then this page becomes reality. Otherwise, it's a nightmare, okay? If it becomes a dream, you're damn lucky, let me tell you. Okay? And there was one guy called Yasha Heifetz that played this perfectly. And what you have to do, once you work out these bars, each one systematically, because now we're coming into a whole different other, I'll show you in a minute. Once you work out all those aspects up to the theme, the trill, okay, in slow rhythm, you put the metronome on, a very slow three, which is what it's written in, and you try and fit all that information into that 3-4. Because right now you played it in, sometimes in four, sometimes in five, because you felt the music, but because you're not balanced here, you're not in control of that emotion that you're trying to express because of your physical, it becomes unbalanced. So therefore the ear to the listener, it says, gee, what's wrong with that? We can't quite tell. You understand what I'm saying? Okay. So now let's just play for a minute more, starting here, da, 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 from the B flat. This is an exercise, remember. Lift. And come back, right away, so you're ready to play the next one. But watch what I'm doing. First chord. See, it resembles this, right? Okay, well, do that. Same feeling. Once more. Watch your wrist. Before you play the chord, stop for a split second and curl your fingers so you're ready to play that chord. Good. You see what you did? You had to adjust your fingers. Right. Feel that. But come right back. Come back so you're ready to play the next one. Intonation, once more. No, you didn't. You weren't quick enough. After the chord, come right back. Back. Is that clear? Okay. You do that for about 2 days. 15-minute hours, just the first two lines. 15-minute hours, 3 hours, that's all you need. 15-minute hours, take a 10-minute break, okay? And I promise you, in 3 weeks, you'll feel a lot better. Because it'll sound better. Anything else you want to know? Because there's a lot more here. The next one is a little easier. What you do is save, travel. Too much of this, not enough of that. Well, it gives you a chance. Gives you a chance to do all that, right? So. As you apply the bow to the long note, travel, release, catch, release. The more pressure, more speed. So. Now you're really utilizing the whole bow. Good, one more time. Open the fingers, open it. Yeah. Scoop. Okay, the minute you start thinking more about the right hand, you lose the intonation in here. So be aware of that. Fix yourself immediately. Don't let me do that every time. Go ahead, once more. Yeah. Look how close it is. Yeah, remember, readjust. Immediately. Go on, once more. Save. Travel. Okay, now play from here again. Okay. Of course, we do it a lot slower. Hey, it's much better already, you see. You're already in the right, you have the right train of thought now. And it already sounds better. So there's six, it sounds four, blah, 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 blah. That becomes the music. See? Okay, now play once here. Nice and easy. You're playing music. Don't play the music. Just play the arm. Adjust. While you're playing, you can do it. No, that's not quite right. Nice. Paper mache. Yes. One, two, three. One. Now, the minute you play legato, divide into four. Big difference, okay? Save the bow. Save the bow on the down bow. Don't get stuck with your elbows. Don't get stuck with your elbow. Don't force. Don't force. Just let the bow speak for itself. Yes. Save now. Travel. Hey, what's the tempo? Yadi dadi dadi. Brahms exercise. Dadi 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 dadi. Save. 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 Fix your hand. Finally, fermata. You see, that's what I'm doing for you. See, that was the metronome, but even slower. Okay, that's a half an hour. But wait. If you do this for the next 3 to 4 weeks, just like that, if you can remember all of it, okay, slow down. Slow everything down. You want to play so much that you're actually going against yourself. All right? Please do that. And watch your intonation. And practice scales. Also, holding the ball, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24. The ball goes in the same speed. Do it with a metronome. 60 to the quarter. Okay? Right? Okay, it'll help you with this. Then you'll have 6-5-4-3-2-1. Johannes will be very happy. Because that's what he wrote. Right? So we have to comply with what he wrote. Thank you very, very much. Yes. Any questions, remarks, affiliation to Borms, misunderstood, understood? I get this kind of reaction usually in Tokyo at the Toho School. We're not in Tokyo. Come on. Yes. Mic up. Mic up. Get that mic up. Yes, sir. Good question. Both. You will now wait a minute. Yes, you can. Should you? No. Might you? Yes. What do you want to know? What is that? What am I doing? Am I holding it with the left hand? Okay, what am I holding it with? What else? What? Speak up. Did you say chin? So it's a balance right away. See? People complain that you hold it up. No, you don't hold it up. You hold it up, we don't hold it up. Okay? It lies on the collarbone, right? But the chin is very important. People say the shoulder. What shoulder? Shoulder, it comes there. Now we have to hold it. You're holding it with the chin. You don't hold it with the shoulder. The shoulder is a balancing. It's support. So sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down. Most of the time, it starts to be a problem, this process that I just showed you, because we've got the left hand grabbing the instrument. The way you don't grab the instrument, you release it with the right hand. So when we start, there's no holding the instrument. And we move from the waist. So ostensibly, you've got two steps. You've got this way and this way. You can do it like this, or you can do it like this. Okay, depending on where you have to go. But it works in such balance that you can't tell if it's the arm, it's the shoulder, the toches, doesn't matter, okay? Anything to get it to sound. But there's a process of how to get it to hold properly, to hold the instrument. Obviously, what you need to do is to start somewhere around here. Well, you do it with little ones. David will tell you that at the Perlman camp. They go like this. Ostensibly, they put it here. There's a square, okay? Can you see the scroll peripherally? Yes, you can. Can you see the scroll? No, that's too far. See, there's no longer a square. Can you see? That's no longer a square. So the square has to be there. See the square? Now some people say, yeah, but some people only hold it with the... You know what? Perlman holds it with the hand a lot. I don't play like that. He plays like that. But it doesn't mean he doesn't know what he's doing. Once you've achieved a freedom of sound, expression, emotional outpouring of your feelings, and God bless you, if you can do it upside down, go ahead and do it. Okay? but there's a process. So it's not one thing only, but terminology is very important when you start asking, how do I do that? You go, how anybody else does that? And that's why it's very important when you teach, if there are any teachers in this room, terminology for a young person is very important, okay? Because it's everything is a process of balancing. We have two sides of the brain, unfortunately. Freud will tell you that. So if we have two sides, that means we have to balance them all the time. Otherwise, you couldn't walk, okay? You couldn't play. And it's a process. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I know you from somewhere.
I played in Civic.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Okay. Try something right away with you, okay? Don't worry. Give me. Have you ever played with that one?
No.
Oh, good. That means you don't have any problems. Hold it without the hand. Hold it with your chin. Chin. Left foot. Hold it. Shoulder and chin. Hold it. No. You can go away. Go to Starbucks. Have a beer, come back. She'll be fine. They're all worried for you. My God, I can feel the tension in the room. Woo! This is cool. What are you doing to her? Poor baby. Oh, my goodness. Here, how's that? Bring your head over a little bit. That's not, okay. Now hold it. Don't relax your arm. Relax your arm. Hold my hand. Hold it. Is that too much? Maybe it's too much. That cushion is too much. Anybody got a handkerchief? Yeah, hold it with your shoulder, can you? Without your left hand. And move from left to right. Without your arm. Without your arm. It's not quite right. Yeah, it's not. That cushion is mine. It's a little bit too thick for you. Anybody got a handkerchief? How about some foam rubber? Yeah. Let me try that. Thank you, David. Let's try this. Okay. He's a doctor. He knows. Hold your fiddle for a second. Let me, I have to fold it up a little bit. You see, you have a little valley here. I have a huge valley. This is not doing anything to the valley. It's just, if you break your knee, you'll have to put that on. So you can't move it, see? That's what a doctor would tell you, because it has to repair itself, you see? And you can't go backwards at all. Forget about it, okay? You don't need this.
Okay.
But I'm trying to find the proper amount there, thickness, so you can, and this is just a piece of material that goes under a carpet, so it doesn't slide, which I got from a student of mine a long time ago. When she changed to no crutch, what I call. Okay, let's see. Can you hold this for me?
Mm-hmm.
A V is better. Two rubber bends is better. It goes back and forth. Right, David? You use this?
No.
Did you try to change it?
Yeah.
And? Because of your neck. I know. You got a huge neck. Okay. Let's do it without a rubber band first. Let's see, find a place. Let me see. Oh, it goes this way. There. Okay, we'll find it, don't worry. Okay, now. Is that better? Too low? You want to put it in further? Put it in further. Give me your bow. Put it where the cushion. Put your cushion where you want. That's a cushion. Where does it feel good? Is that better? Nearly, that's good to start. Okay. You need a different chin rest.
Yeah, probably.
Okay. For the moment, we don't have another one, so let's just do with that. Maybe you don't need anything. Let's just take it out. Just play with that.
Okay.
Just hold it. See what happens. Whoops, sorry. Here, just put it on your shoulder. Pick up your fiddle. This is so the fiddle doesn't slide. Just put it on there. You don't need it for that much. Not quite, right? We're getting there. Don't worry. It's in front of everybody. There. Let's see. Try again. Okay. You need one that goes over the tailpiece. Okay. Now just try and hold it. Feel the instrument going against your collarbone here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Relax. Hold it with your shoulder. hold it. So what you're doing is you're meeting this together with your chin. Push your chin down. Both same amount of weight. Both ways. Up and down. Hold it. I don't know why it's sliding so much. It shouldn't slide so much. Okay. Well, try and play like that. Just play once at the beginning of supervising it. Let me open strings first.
Okay.
Just four strings. Just ba ba. Go ahead, more in the string. I'm gonna do it without left hand. Again? Let's dance. Once more, G. Pick it up. Pick up the scroll. Can you pick up the scroll? That's all right. Don't be sorry. You have nothing to be sorry for. Go. Again. Now hold it with your left hand, exactly the same. So the nose and the scroll, the nose and the scroll meet. Your nose and that scroll, right? Okay? Posture. Posture is so important. Any dancer will tell you that. Go. That's right. Now let me see a lot of that, okay? Down with the wrist. Okay, we have four planes, right?
Mm-hmm.
Four strings, four planes. The elbow, if you put it on the A string, put the A string in the middle of the bow, okay? It mustn't go above the A, okay? If anything, slightly below, okay? And then we have one plane, second plane, third plane, fourth plane, and back again. So the elbow, that's right. I'm gonna hold it here, push it down a little bit, push the elbow. Atta girl, that's right. Okay, now you have to bend your thumb and curl your fingers. Open it up, yeah. Because you're not a small person, okay? Whoever told you that is wrong. You're not a small person. It's a question of angle, okay? Now play that G string again. Ah, yeah, left foot. That's right. And go out. And now in. Yes. Are you holding with your shoulder as well? You forgot about
trying.
It. Did you forget about it? Kind of. You almost forgot about it, right? Almost. Okay. First time, look, it's already better. Yeah, atta girl. Go. Now watch your elbow. Boom. Right. And sustain. Okay, now make exactly that sound. Start on the G, the Sibelius, starts on the G. And the same sound, I want to hear the same sound. And don't give me any of this facial stuff.
Okay.
Play exactly like that, okay? Just take the emotion out of here. All right, just go. Watch where you're starting. You're not starting at the tip, you're starting over here. Okay, there. Now watch your elbow. Nice vibrato. Hey, what's that face? Now, quiet. Watch your elbow. Bring it down immediately. Immediately down. Once more. Save. Bring the elbow down. Save. Now, when you come up here, you immediately. Okay, and don't wait and then do it. It's there. Okay? Curling the fingers helps a lot. You have a wonderful left hand. Don't worry about your left hand. Can you try and concentrate on your right hand? Left foot. Save. Open the posture. Detaché. And catch. Ta-yam. Ba-ba-ba. Catch the F natural. Ta-yam. Catch. Bring your elbow down before. Down. Once more. Now you don't have to work so hard, you see? sustained. Yeah. It's like your bow is sliding a little bit. It's all so many new things. Anybody? Okay, come over here. Get over here. I want you to do it with him because you play so well. You really play so well. You really do. It's wonderful. David, I want you to go to the square on the A string. Okay? How you doing, boss? Let's see. Hi. On the A string, like you did 3-4 years ago, okay? And just go out. Okay, that's all I want her to do for the next 10 minutes. And watch her direction and watch the plane, okay? Watch the elbow, out, make sure the wrist goes down immediately. She's pressing fingers. See what I'm doing? Do that once. Middle, martelé. See, that's too high already. Bring your elbow down, that girl. Up. Make sure the wrist goes down. Out, in, slow. Catch. Slow, I mean preparation. Catch. And up. And down. Okay. Go in a room somewhere and do that for 10 minutes. Come back. I want to see that. Okay? Use your watcher. Once you go away now. And use that stuff I gave you. Yeah. Find a comfortable place for yourself. Next person. Next person. This is from the Netherlands. Ooh, it's a good one. I've never seen one of these. Okay. Any questions? Yes?
Do you suggest not
No. I don't suggest anything until I see it. Depends on the person. Hi. Or you put your hand there and you just, with no pressure on the strings, and then you do two, and then three. Eventually, you come here. Again, no pressure. No pressure to start with. Just so you get the finger curled, very relaxed. Because you've been doing this all your life, okay? So you have to change that. It's a whole set of new muscles. And then eventually you put on a D on the A string. Two, three, and watch your direction. One, two, three, four. Whoa, 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 whoa. That's what you want. You want that knocking. And eventually, you squeeze a little more, it goes less knocking. But not right away, because you start using the arm again. It's a physiological phenomenon. Here, there's no problem. As we come up, it stops. It goes from this set of connections to this set of connections. Okay? And then we have to develop it. Because we've heard all these CDs and everybody goes, we use the arm. That's wrong. What you want is to relax. I didn't have a wrist vibrato at all until I was about 15 or so. Okay, and I had to learn how to do that. Now I teach it that way. And you just have to have a lot of patience. And within about 6, 7, 8 days, if you just do that, and that release motion, you will find that this muscle, all of a sudden, you can feel this muscle in here. My muscle here is almost twice as big as this one. That's it. Yeah, you know, Galamian basically just used a lot of this sort of feeling. We start without the violin first. And you can lean on a table. Same thing. Lean on a table, go down first. Because the down motion you're controlling, because gravity, it comes right back. See? If you control the up motion, there's no way to go down. So it's a down motion first to start with. And then the hand falls in the right place so the pitch is correct. All right? It's practice, what can I tell you? Okay. We'll come back to that, that's good. See, you're all worried about your left hand. I don't worry about the left hand, I worry about the right hand. Eventually that works by itself. If you're free, you can only free your left hand by your right hand. There's no other way to do it. You cannot free it by vibrating. I don't hear anything. Do you hear anything? Oh my God, I'm praying, I love it. Ooh. Rubbish. Okay. Country?
3 months.
3 months. And do you speak English?
Yes.
And you learned English in Germany?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And you are from Munich?
No.
No? Where are you from?
I spent most my life in Dresden and Leipzig.
Ah, you're from over there. Okay. And so you studied with a Russian person, or you study with?
No.
No? German teacher in Dresden.
Uh-huh.
So when you play Mozart, do you, right now, were you thinking or feeling it in German, or were you feeling it in English?
That's a tough question. But I tried to adjust to the stuff.
No. Just tell me what you did. Don't try to adjust. It doesn't matter what they think. I'm very curious for myself.
Oh, I mean, this music is related to Europe.
No, wait. The answer trips. The question. I know. But were you... You're funny. I like that. It's good. It's a good sense of humor. So you right now, what did you do? You thought in German, of course.
Yeah.
Gefühlweise. Yeah.
The pictures are not American pictures.
American pictures in German?
No, they are not American.
They're not American pictures. Bravo. Very good. I like that. I really like that, because they all should study German. Because of what you were trying to say, which is, it belongs to the language. This music belongs to the language. That means Kultur mit an K.
Okay.
Yeah? You know what I'm talking about. Do you know what I'm talking about? You see, they don't know. Okay, never mind. It's a different subject, not for now, but it belongs. Because there are certain words and certain sentences that we say in German about music, all music, that you cannot translate. It's a phenomenon. You cannot. For example, in English we say we came to a quarter rest. There's a quarter rest.
Mm-hmm.
How can you say that in German? Ein Viertel.
Yeah.
But pause is not rest. Okay? There's no translation for pause. We think there is, because we've gotten too used to it, okay? Which means it's an anticipation. An Achtel geht weiter. Bis Fermata. Ne? Dann haben wir eine Pause, eine wirkliche Pause, ein Rest, eine GP, Generalpause, noch mehr. Okay, that's important. So, A dur is not A major. Okay, A major. At least we should say La majeur. You know, A
Mozart
major.
Mozart didn't speak English clearly, but.
It's maybe a good thing.
Who knows?
We have to learn, in other words, what the significance of the languages are. There's no question. Because a fermata, I was shocked when I first arrived in Italy and I saw fermata on a bus stop. They said, wait a minute. I said, no. Okay, so that's good. Now, but nevertheless, I think what I have a problem with is explaining my concept of musizieren. How do you translate that?
Music making,
okay. Because, yes, of course it comes from knowing Mozart, knowing language, knowing Kartoffelsalat in Wien, because it's the mayonnaise, it's not the potatoes. It comes from chamber music. It comes from all the knowledge. But in order for me to bring it out, it has to come from a Mercedes-Benz and the latest model. That, in Germany, they don't want to hear about. Honest, they don't. A few now, in the last decade. So when I give a class like this in Germany, inevitably somebody will say, well, why don't you talk about the music? I said, I am. And they said, but you didn't. I said, I did. I said, Brahms has 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. He wrote forte, then he wrote piano, then he wrote dolce. I know all that. They know all that. So why not? Because if we can't do it, how do you do that? How do we explain the music making without the Mercedes-Benz?
You mean the technique?
You see, you already break. Yeah, technique. How do we explain it to our friends in Dresden? Because they sit there and they go.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? I'm exaggerating a little bit, of course. Okay. So when
I
you.
Hope I didn't play like that.
God forbid! No, I'm not talking about you.
Okay.
But I'm coming at you because I want them to understand something. Because I really work on both sides of the ocean, what I call the pond. in my mind all the time. Because it's so important. People will basically say, we must learn languages. Of course we have to learn languages. And you must go to the museums. Well, of course you have to go to the museums. But where is it coming from? It's the people. Okay. Velasquez didn't just go one day and say, I'm going to do this. He was tormented. Why was he tormented? We have to learn about the epoch, about the time he lived there. And it goes on and on like that. Right? Same thing with Mozart. Okay? Same thing with Beethoven. But we have to know where they came from because of the language. The language. The color of the place. The color. The color of Dresden is different from Bavaria. Isn't it?
Okay. And from Salzburg.
And from Salzburg, of course. So, when you start, basically it's an A major triad, A major chord. Okay, so why don't you just play A, D, E? Just play that, like a scale. Okay, now play it like Brahms. Play it like Brahms. A little slower. Da da dee da dee da dee da. Okay. Now do Mozart here and Brahms here. Aha. Okay, now if you can just, for now, if you can go a little bit this way on a down bow, and then a little bit this way on an up bow, it'll help you. And without, Ulrike, without that, yeah. Relax. Brahms. It's a little bit stiff, huh? If you could just, yes, a little more motion. Okay, the elbow, I'm doing this for them. The elbow has two functions. It goes this way, and it goes this way. Okay, this is out. Out, in. That's right. Okay, let's not forget Brahms. Okay, that's, to me, that's a better sound. Conceptually, just for sound. Now we can lighten it up. We can make a little more up, we can go a little down, depending on what the harmony and what Monsieur Ludwig wanted, Monsieur Wolfie wanted, okay? That's all you have to do.
Okay.
That's all it is, it's a triad, okay? Do it again. Don't forget the left hand. Support. Nice smile. Smile. It's A major. Okay, you understand the concept. It opens up. Yes, it opens up. You're moving this way. That's a little bit wrong for me. Don't go away. Where's that girl? Yeah, she'll come back now. Stay here. Do you understand what I was just talking to her about? Please tell me if you didn't. And if you don't, it's okay. Because we struggle with that all the time. When I work in front of a German orchestra, I don't think in English. I am not an English-speaking person. Do you understand that? McDonald's? Yeah, they all know McDonald's, of course. But it tastes different. Come here. Give me your arm. So so we have more time. Come on. Now watch what you're going to be doing, okay? Go ahead. Let's see what you did. Your wrist is too high. Right, okay. More in the middle. Stay more in the middle. Make sure it doesn't slide. The bow doesn't slide. The bow. Okay, that's good. You can now loosen the bow even more because he made you play with... Hey, David, you're good. You made it play with flat hair. What we call flat hair? Okay. Index finger starts and stops the bow. Stay flat already. Don't go so much. That's right. That's better. Elbow, relax. I'll give you a little bit. Yeah. Now push. Push. There you go. That's the sound. More bow now. Now go to the tip. And out. Make sure it doesn't slide. That's damn good. David, you're a really good teacher. You better buy him a drink, okay? He doesn't take money yet. He's below age. He's not supposed to. But you can buy him a drink. Okay. Now, I want you to do da, 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 stop. Da, da, da. Middle, yeah. Out, stop. Adjust. For balance. In, out. Let's open it up a little bit. There. In, out. Out. Good. Now, just play open A and open D. And I'd like you, can you just, let me show you. It's better if I don't speak so much. Start up O in the middle and cross. You were late. Right. Quick. Watch clean. No, it's not clean. Index finger. Don't forget the index finger. Watch your elbow. Stay down. Down, down with the elbow. You don't need so much. You don't need to do this. It goes by itself. See? Just guide it. Elbow is guiding it. Yeah. Yes. That's better. Okay, now we want to start down bow, because music is metaphors. Okay? Ah, late. Out, catch, out, and cross right away. Three things you have to think about. A lot. That's better. Yeah, out, cross. Go do, David, go do that for 10 minutes. Go on, and do question number 7. Okay, once he gets it, curtain number 7, 1 bar. You know what I mean? Yeah, good. Oh boy. So, all right, do that again. All right. What you need to do is posture. You need to try and bend from your wrist, from your waist, okay, a little bit, and move this way. That's right. So down bow is this way. That's right. No, let's not do that right away. Just one string is enough. Index finger. Is that one index finger in Deutsch?
Zeigefinger.
Yeah. But stay there. Stay there for balance. Jawohl. Yes. Out. Catch. Posture. Die Nase muss mit mit die Geige, von Kopf und Geige. Ungefähr. Ne? Catch. Flat here. Flat here, yeah. You can hear the sound immediately. But try and play only here for now. So when you stop, you're stopping at the square. You want to stop here. That's the square. See the square? Okay. Once more. Good. Catch. Catch. Good. No, you didn't go out. In, now out. For sounding point. Sounding point. How do you say sounding point in German?
Doesn't exist.
Kontaktstelle doesn't exist. See? That's right. That's why we have to learn English. Okay, don't be so stiff. You don't need to stiffen up. You hold it, hold it, hold it, but don't. Your hand was going blue.
No, it's just cold.
No, no, but I saw the fingers going blue. You're pressing so hard. Press over there. Forget your left hand. But hold it here. Just on the bottom here, on the bottom. Why don't you hold it here? There. Go out. In. Mirror. Where's the mirror? Good. You go and work with David. He'll show you. He'll come back again. Okay? That's a process of 2 to 4 years, which has many, many, it's a menu. It's a huge menu of everything you ever wanted to know about how to play the violin. It automatically transfers to making what we call making music. Each person will apply that knowledge according to the way they want to do it, or to their ability. I can't force you to do something you don't want to do. I can tell you I don't like it, but you may end up doing it, but at least you'll be doing it properly. It will still sound okay. So you then have the choice of correcting yourself. In other words, you're opening up a well with this information of how to acquire more knowledge. You open up your ears, you open up your mind with this big, wonderful path of what we call technique, okay? It's not so difficult. It's a global problem. We all have it because we all are born the same way, okay? Yes. There was a question. The relationship. I don't quite understand what you mean by relationship. Oh, I see. Well, let us go back even further. Ostensibly, or for the basic of it, you need to meet, the thumb has to go in the corner here. The corner of the thumb has to go on the frog here. It's already bent. Because this way, you can put tonnage on here. It will never break. This way, it collapses immediately. Okay? So slightly bent already at that spot. Hopefully you're not double jointed. Okay? So you go there, you then put the second finger. Second finger meets, again, on the first knuckle. First knuckle of the second finger meets the bow, the thumb, and then the rest just comes down naturally with the pinky going on top of that square here. Straight on. And you just, it's a handshake. It's not this way, it's not that way, okay? It's very simple. Can you see it? Okay. Once you start moving the bow, you begin to feel the shifting of the of the weight, and it goes to the pinky. This is when it starts to become a problem. People start holding on to it. Little kids, they start doing this. So the Suzuki method is quite good. Monkey on the stick, okay? Because it develops those muscles back and forth. And they'll start to cheat, you know, go, okay? So, and always slightly bent, with the bow straight up, the spitz, the tip, because there's no weight. Once they do that and they're feeling okay, you then go there. But come to a landing, and they'll see that they don't have to use the weight anymore. Now bring it back up, there. It's this way, what we call a scoop, eventually. Okay, so what's driving it beats me. I don't know. You'll figure it out eventually. It's a combination. It can't be driven this way, and it can't be driven that way, and it can't just be driven this way. It's a combination, all right? And then, of course, the arm. And that's why we start with a square. Theoretically, if you like, the elbow really is the one that moves first. But God, don't play like that. Don't go. Okay? But obviously, the elbow has to move. But it moves because of a reaction. You don't move the elbow because of the slide. Come on. Please think up more questions. I saw you yesterday, right?
Yep.
Yeah. What's wrong with this picture? What's wrong with this picture? Quick, come on, you've been sitting here for an hour and a half. What? It's a viola. Never mind, they don't understand. Obviously, he doesn't play the viola. If he played the viola, he wouldn't say that. What was wrong with this picture? Come on. Quick, how would you tell him to fix it? What? Down. So how do you, what do you tell them? Words, terminology, teaching. The scroll to your nose. Bravo. Scroll to your nose. There you go. That's simple. That's better. Already it sounds better. Okay. Languages do you speak?
Chinese.
How many? I know it's Chinese. How many?
Cantonese, one.
You speak Mandarin?
A little bit.
So you speak English, Cantonese, little Mandarin, what else?
That's it?
Yep. That's pretty good. That's three, right? Okay. Pick up the scroll. And when you plant a down bow, don't go in the same direction. Go the opposite direction. That's right. Do it once more. Start the, and when you start, start right there, the first chord. As you apply the bow onto the string, bring the wrist down. Okay. That's right. Okay? I am. Just do it a few times. Relax, relax your shoulder. So from the string, try once from the string, the chord, from the string. And bend the wrist immediately. The more pressure, speed. Now play the chord, play the chord. Almost like one motion. As you were going, wow. I'll give you a little resistance. The elbow, wait. Resistance. There, again. Oh, you're strong. Then I put the ball on the string. Put the ball on the string. Give me, push me down here, here, here. And go.
Okay.
Again, relax, relax. Just let the fingers do the walking and the yellow pages. Did you ever hear that? In China? No.
No.
Of course not. Did you speak English in China?
A little bit.
A little bit. Okay. He's so cute. Okay. Push. There you go. It's a guy. I can hold him any clothes I want, yeah. Right? Yeah. Good. Go. That's good. Push. Yeah. And pick it up. Pick up. Hand. You can't imagine how stiff this is right now. It's like, it's gonna break. I could just literally go like this, it'll break. That's a better sound. Again, push down. Not so hard. One motion.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it. And lift. Okay, now please play me the four strings, open four strings. Same thing when you press down for the octave. And then take a deep breath and release. Almost. God, it's stiff. Oh, man. Because you're clutching onto this thing. See, he's clutching. Where's that girl? He's clutching. I don't know what leads. Relax. Wow. You play baseball? A little bit? What sports do you do?
Basketball.
If you did this with your arm, if you had the basketball in your hand, what would happen to the ball?
Fall.
Ah, okay, so. Relax. Catch. Yes. You're still so tense here. You feel that muscle in there?
Yeah.
When I'm touching it? Okay. That's good, my friend. That's much better. You did it how many times now? 10? Imagine if you did 1,000 of those.
Okay.
Yeah, but the same way. Exactly. Good. And now, play me the next one on an up bow. Catch and lift. Ta-da-da-yum. Lift, catch.
Okay.
Yeah. Catch. Parallel with the bridge. Catch and relax and pull. Now just ta-da-da-yum, lift. Scoop it. Index finger, you start. Index finger, catch and release. Watch the bow, parallel. Where's your nose? There you go. In here, yeah. Catch. You go in. Just lift it and then play the next note. Lift and down right away with the index finger. Why don't you go do that for 7 minutes?
Okay.
Just like that's all. If you do more, I'll shoot you. And bring the other girls back. Yes. You curl your fingers and bend your thumb. Curl your fingers and bend your thumb. Because the curling of the fingers and bending your thumb prepares the next, you see? I'm already in a down mode. And here, same idea, a little elbow, what we call figure eight. Okay? Can you bring the other girls back, please? Come. How'd you do, David? Okay. Not so good second time, huh? nothing. Well, he's just learning how to teach. It's okay. You're a good subject, let me tell you. How does that feel, by the way, without...
It's better than my old one.
Oh, good. All right.
Whatever
you want to do. You're the boss. Watch your wrist. Watch that wrist. Slow. Too fast. Too fast. You're not giving yourself a chance to prepare. The minute you start, make sure you immediately go out, okay? Bring that wrist down. Slow. Watch your bow. Okay, it'd be easier for you, start up bow. David, that's very important if you're gonna teach. If you see they're having difficulty one way, shift it. Start up bow.
Okay,
she has much easier time up bow. In. Not so fast. Give yourself a chance. There are three things you have to think about. Give yourself time. It's okay. Well, prepare. Out. In. Out. Okay, stop. This is for their information. She's not thinking about the left hand at all. Are you?
No.
Ah, proves my point. I've been trying to tell them that this drives the left hand. Now vibrate a little bit. Let's not forget about the left hand. You're good. Watch that bow. Don't let it slide. More bow. Relax your elbow. Relax. That's good. Posture. Good. Try to use more bow, more to the tip, go to the tip, out, relax your elbow, relax, catch index finger, sound like a tape recorder, don't I? You don't have to play a lot of this, two bars is enough, come back again, do it again, yeah, it's pretty good, in 10 minutes you're doing very well.
Thanks.
You're doing good. Did you ever do this before? Ah, she did it once before, so we're just awakening old habits. Okay, do it again. How old are you, by the way?
I'm 17.
17? Fantastic. Good for you. Bravo. So fast. Prepare. Put your right foot over here, I guess. Yeah. Swinging Kreutzer. Come on, play. Lean on your left foot. That's it. Oh. Listen to that. Isn't that good? Because it's the right proportion of balancing the weight and space of that arm. See? Now you still feel small? Talk to me. You still feel small?
I guess not.
Oh, girl. Not so fast.
Sorry.
It's all right. That's a good sound. That's really good. Okay. Can I do something with you and you take it home? Because I'm going to see you again very soon. We're going to do the last movement of the Siberian Concerto, okay?
Bap,
bap, bap.
Watch. Just try that. Okay. Catch. Stop. Catch. Travel. Stop the ball. Don't worry about playing. Right hand, okay? The first one. First catch. Stop. Don't travel too much. With each up ball, that propels the movement of the ball. Okay? Bring your wrist down immediately. Catch. Now, try and lift at the same time a little bit. Good. Adjust the fingers. Watch your elbow. Lift. 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 And each one the same sound. Lift. Once more from the beginning. You're still doing a little bit too much of that, okay? Here, just break that wrist immediately. But don't do it with the elbow. Don't go like this. Bring the elbow down. Yes. Stop. But the upper needs a little more lift. Remember, the upper also has to have an in motion, right? Okay, once more. Stop. Stop the bow with the index finger, and. You're not going in. Lift! The catch, the catching, catching, catching. You're not catching enough. What the direction? Oh, you want to go do that for a few minutes?
Sure.
Good girl. I like your work ethic. That's really good. Okay? Where's Ulrika? In the meantime, talk to me, please. Yes. Four planes. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Not this way and not this way. Somewhere in between. It's the same level. You need a mirror for that. You will see it automatically in the mirror, okay? There. In the middle with a square. No, I want to see what you did. Matale.
I didn't work with him.
You didn't work with him? Oh, he was busy. Well, then show me what you did anyway. Just do it. Just
listen to your class.
Aha. Well, dude, let's see what you did. Just play the open string. Good. Good motion. Catch. Catch. She is very good. That's good posture. The problem is when we start to play. Catch. Catch. Index finger, yeah. Don't worry, catch it. Catch and release. Yeah. Yeah. What's your violin? Okay. You can start with Mozart. In the middle. Once more. Be careful that the bow, when it goes down, it goes out. Once more. In, out. Out. Play here a little bit too much this way. Mm-hmm. Curl the fingers a little bit. Just let them lean on top. Nice caress of the fingerboard. Ah, you forgot your bow now. In, out. Yeah, once more. Once more, once more. No, your bow is sliding. Out, in, out, in. Okay. Now we play in rhythm. Ti-ya-ta-ta, ti-ya-ta-ta. In, out. Yeah, after the legato, you stop. No, look what you did. Out. Okay, do you understand the concept? The bow, put the bow on the A string. When we start parallel, and it must go out for sounding point. Okay. When the bow meets, when the hair meets the string, there's a sounding point. When you call sounding point, it can't go this way. Okay? Good. And then the opposite. Middle four. Ah, the bow slid. No, you're going. Out. Okay, we will do Kreutzer number 2 a lot. Kreutzer number 2 has 68, 72 examples, bow examples. Mm-hmm. If we can do 25, we can play the violin. Okay, if you take a look at the Galamian Ausgabe, the edition, and it has fantastic things. If you start doing that, you'll feel a lot better. Okay? And when you play, think in English. Try and think in English. Teach yourself to think, oh, A major, nicht A dur. Okay? A major. Okay, today I'm going to play A major. Okay?
Because A dur can be happy too.
It will never leave you. Okay. A major will never leave you. Okay?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Where's the viola guy? In the meantime, yes. Absolutely. Because I'm a good teacher. Because I have a lot of patience. And the less words, I use way too many words because of you guys here. I don't use that many words. Okay? Come, come. Because it's easier to understand. The words already become emotions. No emotion. We divide the right and the left side of the brain. Okay? Let's see what you do. Stiff. Don't try to play loud. Just pronounce. Pronounce. Okay. When you have the long notes, let me hear wah 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 wah. Okay. Yes. Again. Flat here, and out. Uh-huh. Right away, as you make contact, the index finger pushes the bow down, and release, going out, release. Right, again. Right. There you go. Good, that's better. See, if you didn't do that with a baseball, you have to follow through. Follow through. Right? Otherwise, what would happen? The base, you know, the ball goes right there. Foul ball. Easy, easy. Flat here. Contact. And again. Bring the viola up. That's a better sound. But you change the wrist about here. You should do it there. Now. But then, speed. Start parallel. Parallel with the bridge. And out. Yeah. There you go. Repetition. That's where you say the same thing. Eventually he gets it. You see, it's coming. You can see it. You can start seeing it. Very important for teachers. Don't talk too much. Galamian never talked. He sat there, he had a parliament cigarette, crossed legs, with these incredible eyes that we were all shitting our pants. You understand? No, out. Out. Do that. But stop parallel. That's not parallel. That's parallel. Bend your thumb. That's right. Slow. Don't force the sound. Release it. Look, you're not starting. You're starting there. Pick up your instrument. There. Now down. Now don't force. And play right in the middle. In the middle. Bring your wrist down. Just half a bow. Up. Okay, play quicker. Open string. Not so fast. Slow down. In. Up pause in, right? Out. In. Open string. Once more. Think. Put the bow in the middle. Parallel. Down. Go out. Out. That's not out. To me. To the floor. Stay flat here. Bend your thumb. Curl the fingers. Okay? Now up. That's right. Now up. Open string. This is so hard in front of everybody. I don't want to do this anymore. Stop. He would be doing nothing except posture, okay? For the first lesson, I would be doing all kinds of things with him to just release all the bad stuff, okay? There's so much there that's wrong for me. It's just tight. So it's impossible to do it right now. Forgive me, all right? But I'll see you in January. I'll give you a lesson, okay? But try and relax your arm. Bend your thumb, curl the fingers, start parallel with the bridge. Write it down if you need to. Not need to, write it down, okay? When you leave here, all right? Okay, I'll see you in January. It's a couple of months.
Thank you.
What more would you like to know? Yes.
How do you begin a child? At what age? What method? How would you begin that?
I'm not an expert at that. I know that a child should basically be about 6, give or take, depending on growth. But they should have already done something else to learn music, to learn to read music. Recorder is good. Becomes theirs, depending on the ability of the child, how their ear is, how their physical build is. I then would ask them, what instrument would you like to play? And then I would go to the best teacher you can find in your neighborhood, because I don't know how to teach little kids. I can try, but I'm not good at it. So I leave it to other people. I usually get them set up at 13, 14, 15, somehow set up. Then I take over, because I'm better with 14 to 20-year-olds.
Is there a particular cue you
Suzuki is okay, but do it with the child. Suzuki is okay, but then they need a teacher. They have to learn to read music. Don't do just by rote. It's not right. Long term, it's not right. They lose interest very quickly.
Basic question. I'm a beginner. When you use the word catch, sometimes with the ball, but not other times not. What is it you mean by catch?
Index finger. The index finger pushes down the bow, and you would then release it.